All right, now that we're connected to the internet, we're going to configure the Media Center. Do not click on the Media Center. If you have already clicked on it, please pause this video and restart. If you have restarted or if you are already ready to go, you haven't clicked on it yet, let's go ahead and go down by pressing the down arrow on either the remote or any keyboard. And go to this plus character here and click OK or Enter on a keyboard. Now, as you can see by the highlighted boxes, we're moving around. If you press to the left or right on either the remote control direction pad or on the keyboard, you will go to the left and right. If you press up and down, you will go up and down. And notice this does scroll. So what we're going to do is we're going to move around until we find the pack loader, which you can see is highlighted right here. So make sure that that's highlighted on your box, and then press either OK on the remote control or Enter on your keyboard. Now you can see that little check mark there. I'm pressing OK several times just to flash it. So you can see that this is added to the shortcut bar. This is not on the shortcut bar. So if you wanted to remove something once it's been added, you can remove the check mark and it will go away. So we're going to leave the check mark next to the pack loader, and you can see I just removed Gmail. So if we go back, Gmail is now gone and the pack loader is in its place. If you want to add any other items from the list, you can just by going and placing a check mark there, and that will add them. So now we're going to leave the pack loader on there. If you want to add or remove other things, you can come back and do that later. Let's click on the pack loader. And at this point, it's asking if we want the standard pack or the extended pack. This is the only time that it's going to ask you this. So the standard pack is no adult content, meaning rated X material. If you choose the extended pack, it's going to have adult content on there, but it's not real easy to get to, so you do have to look for it, and I'll show you where that is later in the video. So it's not going to be on the shortcuts, so you don't have to worry about people finding it or anything like that. So I'm going to choose the extended pack, hit OK, and I just chose that by using the directional pad and then clicking OK or Enter on the keyboard. It closed itself and opened back up. Now up at the top here, you can see the server version. The version number is the date. So that is 2017, April 13th. What we're gonna do is we're gonna look at a couple of the things that are on this screen. So update pack loader, don't worry about this unless you're specifically given instructions to click that. So do not click on that button. Local file, again, this is not something that you will ever use unless you're specifically given something to use for a local file. Remove partial download and start over. If you're trying to install a pack and it freezes during the download or freezes during the install and you have to exit, cancel, restart the box, anything like that, then you will go ahead and remove partial download and start over. That's what that is used for. It will delete all the temporary files. It'll delete anything that's in the, that's been downloaded. So you can click on that anytime that you need to. You don't need to right now. You haven't done anything, so don't worry about that. All right, so now we're going to install the pack. Don't get ahead of me on this, because we are going to be asked if we want to let pack loader have super user access, which is just a way to make it so that things don't get installed without your permission, so you don't accidentally download malicious content from the internet. What we're going to do is we're going to click on install pack, and then there's a couple of options here. Number one is clear cache and data. If you leave this checked, it's going to wipe everything out, including any favorites that you've saved or anything like that, to give you a fresh start. So if you're having problems, definitely leave that checked. If you have some favorites saved in there, those will be wiped out. So just be aware of that. The basic pack versus not having the basic pack. So the basic pack gives you access to what Streamline is great at: music, movies, TV shows, and cartoons. If you remove that, you're going to get the extras pack, and that's going to have weather in there. It's going to have world news. sports section and a fitness section. So it's things that are not really necessarily great to stream, but some people like to have access to those, so we went ahead and included that. I'm going to go ahead and just do the basic pack. So let's go ahead and hit yes. And now we're going to be asked if we want to give super user access, and we need to go down and select remember my choice forever and then hit allow. Very extremely important. Make sure that you hit those two, because otherwise this will not install correctly. Now at this point, this is how you can tell how fast your internet is. The download, as you can see, is 320 megs right now. It goes up and down from month to month during the different pack updates. But if this ever takes longer than 4 minutes to download, there's a problem with your internet or your Wi-Fi router is too far away. This is why we recommend using Ethernet. Ethernet can be up to 100 times faster. But if this takes longer than 4 minutes, you're having slow connection problems. So as you can see here, mine takes about 30 to 45 seconds. I have 150 megabits and I'm using Ethernet. After this, that will take between 2 and 4 minutes. Don't worry about how long the install takes. It's only the download that is affected by your internet speed. So as you can see, now it's installing, so the download is complete. I'm going to go ahead and stop right now and let this finish. So go ahead and pause the video and start it back up once yours hits 100%. All right, so now it's complete. And so we're just going to go ahead and click OK. And the pack loader will exit. So let's go ahead and go back in it real quick just to check and see a couple of things. So first off, you can see the server version is 2017, April 13th. And now second, your version is 2017, April 13th. So those both match, and we know that we're good. So go ahead and press the back arrow, or you can press escape on the keyboard or the home button. And now let's go into the Media Center. All right, so let's have a quick look around and see what we can see here. First, you can see that we're on Movies. These are all the different movie applications that are on this current pack. These may change from month to month, so just be aware of that. If we go to the left, you can see TV shows and music. So if we start off with music, you can see Pandora. If you have a Pandora account, you can sign in with that information here. If you do not, you can just go over to pandora.com and set up a free account and then use those credentials to log in here. Then you've got radio, podcasts, a few other things on here. This one here, more music add-ons, if you click on that, that will actually open up to a list of all the music applications that are on here. If you press to the left and then hit OK a couple of times, you can see thumbnails, and that just makes things a little easier to find. Now let's go ahead and go back a couple of times. Just press escape or the back arrow, and let's head over to TV shows. So on the TV shows tab, you've got several things listed here. Keep in mind, you can see this arrow right here. This scrolls over. So whenever you see that arrow, you know that you can scroll to the side. So now we can scroll back to the other side, or you can go through. So if you're at the beginning, you can press to the left and it will go to the end, and vice versa. Here's the movies tab again. Here's Kids Zone, and this is the system tab. On the system tab, if you go down and then press to the left, that's how you can get to video add-ons. So if you chose the extended pack, you would be able to find any adult content in here. this is also where you can find anything else that is installed on the box. So all of the different movie apps are installed on here. Some of them may not work. Some of them may be down here because we just don't have a shortcut to them, or they could be in process of being fixed, or they could end up being removed. Up on the top left, you can see now the updates have automatically started. Everything that is installed on the box will automatically update. All right, so once that's done, if you press up on the arrow key, that will take you to the bottom of the list. And then you can press the directional keys to move up and down. You can see there's a couple of the adult content applications right there on the screen. And you can just scroll through that stuff. Now let's press the back arrow a few times and get back out to the main menu. Let's see how everything works. So what we can do to start with is Specto and Exodus work identically. However, they are a little bit different, so they may have different sources. So let's go ahead and start there. Let's go to Exodus. And if we're trying to find movies, we can go to Movies. And there's a few different options of how you can find things. I like to use People Watching because this will show you what is currently trending. What are other people currently watching? So the nice thing about that is if there's a new movie out, or there's a really popular movie because of a new movie that's coming out, and maybe it's a prequel to it or whatnot, that will show up in here. And again, we can go to the left and change this to thumbnails to make it a little easier to tell what's what. And then you can just choose something from here. I'll go ahead and choose Moana. So this will take about 30 seconds, and it's going to go out and scan all of the remaining sources on the internet to find you the best quality versions available for that particular item that you're looking for. And after the 30 seconds are up, it's going to present us with a list ranging from best quality at the top to lower quality as you go down. All right, so looking at this list, we can see that there's some 1080p and some HD sources. If you don't see any of those and it's a newer movie, then the chances are that it's not available in good quality yet, so I would wait. I'm going to go ahead and choose one of these HD ones. All right, so I'm just going to go ahead and pause this right here so that we can go over a couple of things. So on here, you can see volume up and down. If you press the volume all the way down, you're going to get that red mute symbol on the top right. So to fix that, you just press the volume all the way up. You can also use the plus or minus keys on a keyboard. You've got the play button here, stop. And over here, you can download subtitles. And then you would just make sure that it matches whatever it is that you're watching. So if it's a 720, then you can see the 720 down there and compare it and make sure that you're downloading the same quality. And so I'll just choose this 720 right here, and that will download and enable subtitles. You also have the ability to adjust the offset. So if the subtitles don't quite match, you can choose that, and you can go backwards and forwards in tenth of a second increments. And then you can just press the escape button or the back arrow to get out of those menus. And then I'm just going to go ahead and hit stop. So that's the basics on how to actually watch a movie. And I'm going to choose now a movie that I know is not in good quality, just to show you real quick on what that will look like. So you can see that this is a camera screener. So definitely do not watch that. That is some garbage that some idiot was in a movie theater recording it with a video camera. So you definitely don't want to watch something like that. All right. So once it's available in better quality, it will be available on the box automatically. You don't need to do any updates, it will just automatically be updated. So from here you can go into TV shows, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you actually going to the TV shows tab. So the first thing is you see here Specto and Exodus both. If I go to TV shows, you can see that they're both also there because those are good for watching TV shows and also for movies. Other things that are for TV shows is SALTS, which stands for Stream All the Sources, Home and Garden TV, documentaries, TED Talks, Food Network, and the list goes on. I'll use Specto this time since we used Exodus last time, and go to TV shows. Like I said, you can get to the same part through the movies tab. One thing that people like is networks. So for instance, if you, I was watching something on Netflix and I don't remember what it was called. Okay, well, here's a list of all the networks. You can scroll down this list. If you use that blue bar to the right, just by pressing to the right, it'll jump down one page at a time. So here we are to the ends. So I press back to the left, go down to Netflix, and click OK on Netflix. And again, go over and choose thumbnails. And now you can see all of the Netflix TV series. All right. And so now let's go back over here and go into people watching. Again, this works the same way as movies, except for with people watching on TV shows, it's going to show you whatever TV shows are currently trending. So you'll know if something is back in season because it will suddenly start showing up in people watching. So these are all currently trending TV shows. So let's say, for instance, I wanted to go to Game of Thrones. Don't worry, I'm not going to ruin the current season for you. So I'll go down to season 5. And then I'll just choose episode 1 from season 5. And I'm not going to actually play it. So if you haven't seen it yet, don't worry. All right, so I skipped the 30-second load time. We already know that that's there, so I just went ahead and skipped that so you don't have to wait for an extra 30 seconds. So now here's that episode, and these are all different sources for that particular episode. So you can just go ahead and choose one and click on that one and hit OK, and it will start playing. All right, so let's go ahead and exit out of there. And let's go down and do a search. So this works the same in Exodus, and it works for movies or TV shows. Just make sure that you're in the correct one. So if you're looking for a TV show, make sure you're in TV shows. And I'm just going to type in something old. So let's say I Love Lucy. So let's choose I Love Lucy. And then you can see all 9 seasons. And again, if we change this over to thumbnails, so we can see the different covers. And let's go to season 1, and you can see that there were no streams available for that one. So now watch this. We exit out of there and go into Exodus, go to TV shows, go down to search, I Love Lucy. Season 1. There's the pilot episode. And select that. And I just skipped that 30 seconds so you didn't have to watch the little timer going. And there it is. So as you can see, sometimes you may not be able to find something in one place, but that doesn't mean that it doesn't exist. Go over to a different app and try it from there. So here it is. And that's how easy it was. So just because it's not working in one place doesn't mean that it doesn't exist. So definitely try different things. Don't just stick to one application. All right, so now that we know that it's working in Exodus, let's go ahead and add that to our favorites so we can get back to it easy. So what you're going to want to do is hit the back arrow or backspace. Get back to your search. So there's I Love Lucy. And then press the letter C on the keyboard or the menu button on the remote control. That will pull up this menu here. Then go down to Add to Favorites. Now, that will add that to your favorites, and I'll show you where that is in just a moment. Let's go ahead and add a couple more things. So we'll go to People Watching, and let's add the Big Bang Theory. After we change this to thumbnails. So Big Bang Theory, Blacklist, and then I'm gonna go out of here, go back to the main menu, go to Specto, go to TV shows, People Watching, and you can see we've already changed it to the thumbnail view, so it's still set to that. And so now I'm going to go ahead and add this to my favorites in Specto. Now notice this. It's been added to your Specto favorites. So if we go back over here, instead of going to any of these, we can actually go to Favorites in Specto. And you can see it there. So that's how favorites work in Specto. So let's just go ahead and verify that Game of Thrones is working good in Specto. So, yep, that opened right up. All right, so that's how Specto deals with favorites. So let's go back out to the main menu. And this is how Exodus does it. This is how everything except for Specto does it. So you can see they're here in the star menu. So you just click on that star and there they are. Now, if you want to move things around, you can use the menu or the context menu by pressing C on the keyboard. And you can move things up or down. You can also rename them or remove them. And as long as you don't clear cache and data during a pack install, that stuff will stay there. All right, so one other thing. If you go to Movies and then go to Phoenix, go to Phoenix Movies, and then Collections. In Collections, you can find all types of different collections. You can find John Wayne collections, westerns, you can find zombie collections, just everything. So Ace Ventura, Disney collection, the list is just crazy of all these different movie collections. So definitely get in here and take a look at this. So that pretty much covers everything. If you have any problems or questions, please definitely head over to streamlinetv.com and click on that support tab and fill out the contact form so that we can get those problems addressed for you. As always, make sure that anytime that you are having any trouble, any problems at all, you're always going to want to go ahead and reinstall the pack by going to the pack loader and just hit that install button to make sure that you have cleared any possibilities of any problems being in there. If you've already done that and the download took less than 4 minutes and you're still having the problems, then definitely go ahead and fill out that contact form. All right, enjoy, happy streamlining.